in Swahili, prepositions that are used to express location, such as in, at, on, to, and others, are not used with proper nouns. Now, let's consider a few examples just to help us understand this concept, you know, how it works in Swahili by looking at these sentences, okay? So our first sentence here would be, ninafanya kazi, ninafanya kazi katika chuo kikuu. Okay. Now the translation of this sentence in English would be, I work at the university. So I work at the university, or I work in the university. The second sentence we are going to see does not have the preposition. And this sentence that we are going to look at will be, ninafanya kazi chuo kikuu cha Boston. Ninafanya kazi chuo kikuu cha Boston. The translation of this sentence would be, I'm working, or I work at the Boston, or I work at the University of Boston. A third sentence, just to help us understand this concept further, would be like, Bwana Ali anakaa Mombasa. And the translation would be, Mr. Ali lives or stays in Mombasa. All right. So you notice in the first sentence we have the preposition katika, which is at the university, whereas in the second and third sentences we have proper names, Boston and Mombasa, and thus we do not use the preposition in these two last sentences, as you notice with the first sentence. So in Swahili, the locative ni is suffixed to nouns to express English prepositionals, such as in, at, to, and others. Now, let's look at some examples to help us see how this locative ni works in Swahili. So we are going to pick this word, nyumba. Okay, nyumba. And of course, in Swahili, nyumba, the English translation of nyumba is house. Okay. We can actually add the locative ni to nyumba, and so it becomes nyumbani. When translated in English, this would be at home, from home, etc. Now, a good sentence just to help us understand this would be, ninaenda
nyumbani.
And the translation of this sentence in English would be, I'm going home. Okay? Another word that we can use to help us understand this concept even further would be soko. And the English translation of soko is market. Okay? So we can add the suffix ni to the word soko. And of course, it becomes sokoni. And of course, the English translation, this again would be at the market. Or in the market. Or it could be from the market. Okay? A sentence that can help us understand this would be, Leila anatoka sokoni. Okay, the translation of this sentence would be, Leila is coming from the market. Okay.